up, wake up! That away, Chad, that away, Chad!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Come on, defense.
Right there.
Defense! Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Defense!
Thank you. Chad. Bring it out. There you go.
Settle down. Settle down. Settle down. Settle down.
Yeah. Sports, the number one running back in Iowa, decides where he will play college football. And Brad Pouch will feature the Boydenholt Comets. We're on a crash course towards the state tournament again. Sports is next.
Basketball. The Boydenholt basketball team, their boys are undefeated at 12-0 and ranked second in the state in Iowa's Class 1A. As Channel 4's Brad Pouch tells us, the Comets are blazing toward a date at the state tournament.
With eight players at 6'3" or taller, Boydenholt has flown over every one of their dozen opponents this season, and there's no secret to their winning ways. They simply love basketball.
The kids up here are really hungry for being successful in whatever they do, and basketball right now happens to be a real priority, so it makes my job a little easier and it makes it more fun.
We try not to have any letdowns, try to play 100% all game, all the way down through the bench, the subs come in, they play hard, and I guess, that's pretty much we go at it, 100% all game.
Yeah, this is a great place to play. The whole town supports us, basketball is just the number one thing going on around here.
The Comets have all five of their starters back from last year's state tournament team, and they want to run and gun their way to Vets Auditorium again this season with their sights on a state championship.
That's really our number one goal this season. We'd like to win all the games we play, but our top goal is still to make it to state.
I think in the back of everybody's minds, it was there, and I think, we all kind of feel that we have a good team, and I think it's definitely a possibility to have a state championship, yeah.
We think it's a lot more fun to run and push the ball, and of course, the more you run, the more people you can play, and we like to play that way. I guess the kids are convinced of that, too, and in fact, our young kids really like that.
In Hull, Iowa, Brad Pouch, Channel 4 Sports.
And tonight, the Comets travel to Orange City to play MOC Floyd Valley. By the way, MOC FV's only loss this year is to Boydenholt. We will have highlights of that game coming up tonight at 10 o'clock. And if you want to see that game, you should probably already be there, because when they played in Hull, the gym was packed at like halftime of the girls' game. So, and that girls' game starts at 6:15.
And all those guys stuff the ball, it seems like it.
Eight of them. They have eight guys on
that
team.
I would have given to do that once in my career. All right, thanks, Larry. Back after this.
You'll find big savings at
in sports, highlights from high school hoops across Siouxland, including a big battle in Sioux County between Boydenholt and MOC Floyd Valley. Sports is next.
Well, the game of the night was in Sioux County. Surprise, surprise. The second-ranked and unbeaten Boydenholt Comets were taking on MOC Floyd Valley. The Dutchmen have lost just once this season to Boydenholt in Hull, Iowa. Tonight, the Comets were in hostile territory tonight, and they were coming through the gates and ringing in the dough. It was a money bank tonight up there with as many people. First quarter belonged to Boydenholt. Chad Netton gets the feed. Netton would have 9 first quarter points. He picks off the pass here and picks up another bucket. The Comets on top 26-16 after one, but the Dutchman came flying back in the second. Dan Potterbaum gets the feed. His jumper goes in, and it was part of a 36-point second quarter rally by MOC Floyd Valley. Dutchman led at the half 52-44. Travis Corver led MOC Floyd Valley with 23 points, but that would not be enough tonight. Boydenholt puts on a furious second half rally and sinks their free throws down the stretch, and they take it by two, 86-84, the closest game of the year for the Boydenholt Comets. MOC Floyd Valley has lost just twice this year, both times come at the hands of the Boydenholt Comets. Rockwell City Litton.
Thank you. Thank you. Smith and Herter back in for Sioux Center on that dead ball.
Thank you. Thank you.
ball in the basket.
Comets were looking to move their undefeated record to 14-0. Sioux Center was in town for the game. Channel 4's Brad Pouch also in town for that. He joins us now in the newsroom with the highlights.
Larry, Boydenhall had their toughest game on Tuesday night when they lost to MLC Floyd Valley just by two. Tonight taking on Sioux Center, a team that was in the state tournament last season. Comets are number two in the state, and they might have the second best cheerleaders in Iowa. Don't ask me who's number one. Boydenhall had everything going their way early on. Brad Moss gets the steal. They get the ball eventually to Ryan Baker, and the Comets got out of the gate ahead of Sioux Center tonight, 13-0. Now it's more blazing Comets. Chad Netton hauls down the rebound, and he goes ahead to fellow captain Brad Moss, and the senior sinks it. Moss had 12 points this evening. Sioux Center did cut the lead down to 19-9. Brian Earp, the big guy, 6'8", puts it in and gets fouled, but the Warriors just couldn't cut it tonight against Boydenhall. They had a balanced scoring attack from their big man. Nat Netton led the Comets. He dropped in 19, and Craig Hoftheiser had 10. Boydenhall wins this game by 40 tonight. 79-39 was the final. And Larry, we had planned on having Western Christian Unity Christian highlights from Hall, but that varsity game didn't start till about 9 o'clock tonight, so just impossible tonight to get those highlights on.
Well, those JVers should just, you know, stop playing such competitive games.
Yeah, I think they both have good JV ball clubs and freshman ball clubs. I assume those games went long tonight, and that was all the right reason. So maybe we'll have a final later in the sport.
Yeah, by the way, speaking of the final, we just got it. Western Christian wins it tonight over Unity Christian, 80-49. Thanks a lot, Brad. We're going to check out all of the scores now from around Sioux Line. Akron Westfield girls beat Sergeant Bluff Luton 48-48.